As of today, which is the 29th of February 2024, there's lots of articles going around saying that Ubiquiti EdgeRouters are unsafe. I've had emails saying that they should be replaced. Let's take a look at that.
Sheridan Computers, IT, Communications, Support.
This is the email I received yesterday. Hi Sam. Ubiquiti EdgeRouters hack has left their active customers in shock, forcing many of them to switch. Would you like to reach out to 31,398 companies using Ubiquiti routers and make them switch to your networking products? This can be filtered based on your niche. Apart from routers, we hold a customized dataset of other Ubiquiti products, active customers such as switches, camera security, etc. Let me know if this would be relevant and I'd be happy to get back to you with the exact numbers based on countries and regions you'd like to focus on. If you sent me this email, congratulations, you made it straight onto my block list. By reacting to this email, not only are you making yourself look stupid, but you make me look stupid giving out the advice that is in this email. It's absolutely ridiculous. Before I boot this up, I've got the Edge router connected to LAN 2 on my computer. So if I pull the IP address up, we've got media disconnected. But I've got my interface set to DHCP, so let's power it up. Now I've got the console set up so I can see when the router's actually booted. So one thing that the articles get right is that it is in fact running Linux, Debian Stretch to be exact, and this one is on the latest firmware, but that's irrelevant. Debian GNU Linux 9 Stretch. The Edge router's booted. We've got the login prompt, so we'll be able to log into the GUI. Oh, you'd think so, because it's that insecure. So let me just pull PowerShell back up again. Now, if I do that again, we've still got an IP address that's unassigned, 169.254. So we've not actually got an IP address because this Edge router doesn't have DHCP running. So no DHCP servers, we've no way of connecting to that router until we manually select an IP address that's in the same subnet as that router. And in order to do that, I'm going to change adapter settings to LAN 2. Let me just set its IP address to 192.168.1.10. The subnet's fine. Okay, that. So now we're on 192.168.1.10. I've manually had to give it that IP address. So we can pull up the web interface now. So the warning is just because it's got a self-signed certificate. This is a web interface for the Edge Max. So what we're going to do is log in with the default credentials of UBNT. Is that insecure, considering it's on a non-routable IP address? So it's on a local IP. And our Cisco router is insecure because they come with Cisco and Cisco. So do not share. As you can see, this is set at factory defaults. Okay, so we've got the routers in the default config. Do you want to start with the basic setup wizard? This is the first screen that you're presented with on login. So yes, we'll do the wizard. If you click no and plug your internet cable in, So you've got to set your own internet connection type. So default is DHCP. Look at this. The default rules that are ticked on the wizard are enable the default firewall on the EVE 0, which is going to be your WAN interface. So enable default firewall for IPv4 and IPv6. Let's scroll a little bit further down. So obviously you can configure your LAN ports here on the range. And we want to set, look, we're prompted to specify the default username and password. It's not by default letting me set this up with just without changing the default credentials. If I did something stupid like keep existing user, like I'm about to do, then yeah, of course the default credentials will be presented, will be stored. So if we apply that, and I need to reboot, so yeah, reboot, yes, I'm sure, and let the system reboot. We can see that rebooting in the background. I'm going to plug that in there. Let me get an internet connection and plug that in there. Yeah. Let's just wait for the Edge router to reboot again. So we're rebooting. All I've done is obviously change the configuration for the WAN interface and swap the cables over, so when it reboots we'll be able to log back in and then see how insecure it is. We've booted again, so let's log back in with my unsafe credentials, because I specifically said keep the default credentials. I had to click keep the default credentials. Let's go ahead and log in. So our Edge router is up and running. Let's have a look at the, so hang on, what the, so internet is on Eve 0. You can see this down here. No, you can't. Which has got an external address of 10.1.10.111. Can I connect to that? No. And if we take a look at the firewall, one interface obviously set. One in. The default action is drop. How is that insecure? Do you physically need to do something stupid to allow this box to be abused over the internet? Am I missing something? If you had concerns about using Edge routers, I hope this addresses some of them. If you found this video useful, please hit the like button. Consider subscribing to the channel. Stick around, there'll be some more videos you might enjoy. I'll see you in the next video.